Hello, my name is Elena Yushchenko and this is my YouTube channel, which is devoted to the novel Master and Margarita by a famous Russian writer, Mikhail Bulgakov. If you have not watched the previous videos, you'd better do it now, because every new video and every new idea is closely connected with the previous ones. For today, I will give you some hints about Woland's arrival to Moscow. But to begin with, I would like to draw your attention that each researcher makes up his own hypothesis on the basis of his speculation about the novel. I don't do anything of the kind. I am a linguist and I analyze and I study the text. For example, if you take one phrase in the beginning of the novel, for example, a Jeshua's statement about a temple of a new belief, you will find the other statement in the end of the novel by Woland, who says that a new building will be constructed. If Jeshua speaks about spiritual values, Woland transfers them into physical world. And coming back to the idea why Woland has come to Moscow, I would like to give you some hints which perhaps can push you to some understanding of this idea, what I'm driving at. To begin with, when Ivan is trying to follow Professor and his companions, he thinks that they are the Trinity. And you know what Trinity means. Then, when Sokov comes to Woland's apartment, he notices some tablecloth, he notices some divine light in the room. Also, there is one more person who notices chandeliers and who notices some divine signs in Woland's room. It's Margarita. And actually, all these things in Woland's environment should give you some understanding that Woland is not a simple messenger, is not a simple executor of some will. He is some power. And also the beginning of the novel makes you compare Woland with Mephistopheles, because the beginning of the novel starts with the epigraph from Faust by Goethe. Actually, the plot of the novel is a little bit different from the one that was in Faust. In Faust, the main plot was seduction of a person, while in Master and Margarita, it seems to the reader that Woland comes to Moscow to punish people for their sins and release Master in the end of the novel. However, it is not exactly the truth. I am deeply convinced that Bulgakov wanted to express another idea in his novel. It is the beginning of the 20th century. It is believed by Christians that the Savior would come back in 2000 years. But before his second arrival, there will be Judgment Day. And so, Jeshua says to Woland, come and check if they are ready for my second arrival. And this is what Woland says at Varieté's performance. They are ordinary people, like they always used to be. There is no difference. He says that people have not changed. So there is no space for Jeshua, for the Savior, to come back to this place. And actually, this is what I think is the truth in the novel, because Bulgakov was born in a very Christianic family. His father and his grandfather were priests in church, and this is why Bulgakov knew the Testament better than nobody else, and this is why he had the knowledge which enabled him to show some Bible plot in a metaphoric way. You know, when a writer wants to represent some idea, but in a different meaning, he usually uses allegory. And this is what actually Bulgakov did in his novel. He just gives some understanding to the reader that although you can see some divine things, chandeliers with seven candles, tablecloth of gold, then some hints upon triple nature of Woland, just like Trinity, yes, Koroviev, Behemoth and Woland. It's not what you think. Actually, Woland shows some religion symbols, but for those people who can understand them, interpret them in their own way. While Bulgakov says that even this evil power is just a messenger of good, because evil is always a part of good. And here you can compare Bulgakov's novel with Milton's. There is one famous work by Milton, Eden's Lost. Here, in this novel, Eden's Lost, you can find the scene between Godson and Godfather when Godfather says that about Satan, that he will seduce the men and they will fall. So he knows from the very beginning about the events in people's life. And this is why in Bulgakov's novel there is the similar scene that Jeshua knows, and he wants Woland to express his will on the earth, and this is why he also sends Levi Matvey to him in the end of the novel to release Master and Margarita. Thank you if you have watched this video. Next time I will tell you about the idea of light and rest in the novel, and I would analyze the episode with Woland and Levi Matvey. If you do not have a subscription for my channel, you can do it now. You can also follow me in Instagram and in Twitter. Thank you for your time. Wish you a nice weekend. See you next time.